Hello. So in today's session, we will discuss on how we translate switch case statement into intermediate code format. So we have to translate switch case into headless code format. So before that, we discuss about switch case statement. The switch or case statement is available in many languages. The switch statement syntax is common like that. According to that expressions, we have to define the cases. So there is a selector expression in our switch file. We have to be validated. First of all, the expressions might be. If that expressions will match to this given case value, then the statement will be evaluated. If it is not, then we have to evaluate the default value and default value in order values which are matched on that switch parameter values. So this is the second way of the switch case statement. We have to use the test statement for our and discussion templates. So now question arises, how we translate the switch case in different code format. So first we have to evaluate the expression. First we have to evaluate the expression E, which is provided to the switch statement. And the second step is that we will find the value G0 in the list of cases that is same as the value of the expression. Let me discuss the key value of the expression. We have to check that value is matched for the cases that we have. If it is matched, then we have to execute the particular statement for the cases. Means it's our third statement. So third step, execute the statement SHA associated with the value. If the value is not associated with the value is not found, then we have to develop the statement which is the default. So these are the three steps for the translation of the select for the translation purpose. So for the translation purpose, second step is an anyway branch which can be implemented in one of several ways. So if the number of cases is small, in the case of just two case 3 or two case 10, consider that. If the number of cases is small, say 10 at least, then it will be able to use the sequence of conditional events. Each of these cases for an individual event transfer to the code for the corresponding statements. If the cases are this small, then it is easy for the compiler to jump as a sequence manner. But if the cases are exceeds more than 10 or equal to our limit, it is more efficient to construct a hash table for the cases. If the cases are exceeds, then we have to take other kind of technique for the implementation of the cases. So if the number of values is 10 or so, it is more efficient to construct a hash table for the cases. Technique to the hash table with the labels of the various techniques of the labels. If no entry for the value for this file switch is confirmed, the jump will be possible. Switch expression the hash values, and we have to give the hash values to the cases as well. If the hash values are not, then we have to give the particular case. In directly we have to jump the hash values here, not a sequence we have to scan each other. If no entry for the value suggested by the switch expression, obviously if the hash values are not found identical to cases values, then we have to jump default statement and jump here. So another kind of technique is here. There is a common special case that can be implemented even more efficiently than by an emergence. If the values are all lines some small ranges, same int max, and the number of different values is a reasonable fraction of the max mean. We will construct an array of max mean values. We have to j mean containing the label of the system in the energy. Any bucket that may otherwise will be equal to contain the algorithm. I think that another kind of technique we have to use ranges, since we have to divide values in the ranges pattern. And that range of values is nothing but we have to define by the variable. So, and as well as the function is going to max time. And so likewise, consider to recreate the buckets and the buckets and then specific ranges. And that ranges is the values found in our hash file. Then we have to find that value in a particular bucket. If it is not, then we have to find that value in a default bucket. That default bucket is not contains any kind of value. So, not empty, we contain, but it contains other than the values from the basic. So now we discuss about how use the syntax validated definitions for this system. For that, we have to take an example. In the first slide, we discuss about how we write switch case statements in the syntax for the switch case statements. And that is switch, we have to pass the value of switch as given to. And according to that, we have to value our expression value, we have to find a particular case for the value. So this setting is translation of some statement. So how translate that this code into translation sequence by syntax and form? Translate, we have first we have to see the keyword switch to generate two new levels, test and next is the one kind of label, and the second is temporary T part. So these two labels are generated after the seeing the keyword switch. Then the parse the expression in into T. This first part is nothing but E, nothing but our head expression. That expression is going to generate the code to evaluate E into T. After processing E, we generate the jump go to test. First, we have to check the switch. The switch generates the two new levels, either test and next, and secondly temporary. Then we have to process the second symbol is nothing but E. This E. After the parse expression E, we generate code to evaluate E into T. This we have to convert that E into T. T is nothing but temporary value. After processing E, we generate the jump go to test. This happens. This is the code to evaluate E into T. Go to test. Then we see the key statement, so key keyword. We create new label and enter it into the symbol array. This after creating the case keyword, we have to create a new label like li is l1 and it's a first principle that case v1 for the case v1 we have to create a new label as l1 and the l1's values we have to pass into the symbol table. We place in a queue user only to store cases a value label pair consisting of the value vi of the case constant and li. After the we process each statement case v1 colon s1 is like case v1 equals s1. After reading this, we have to emit that by emitting the label li attached to the code for s1 followed by the jump go to next. This will be if t is equals to v1, go to here the l1 switch. L1 is nothing but our code for the particular statement path. In simple, we say that key. We have to create the label for each and every case. That label is nothing but one kind of the table that stores the value for the particular statements
as well as the one pointer. That pointer points to the next part here. Next part is nothing but it says the next label we have to choose. So for the test part consists particular condition where T is nothing but the expression values. If the expression values is matching to particular V1, we have to go to L1. L1 is nothing but our label part that is towards a particular statement part. Likewise, this is our test part. So now how we convert that the given syntax and translation to three address space. So three address space consists right side consists at least one operator format. So for the case T V1 L1, case T V2 L2, case T V N minus 1 L1 L N minus 1, S T T L N next. In the case T, VYLI instructions synonymous for AT is equals to VI2PLI is for the generation of thread code. We have to maximum focus for the test part here because all these are stored into our symbol table. So we have to convert the codes for only test purposes. This is our required code for the test purpose statements. So these are the case 3 address code instructions using the translated switch statement. The case T VIL1 instruction for VIL1. Thank you.